thousands of people on the quay cheering and screaming because Douglas Fairbanks and Mary Pickford were on board. We thought we'd never get down the gangway.
Did you see them close to?
Oh, yes. They walked down the promenade deck every morning, however rough it was. Alvin Baxter was actually introduced to them in the dining saloon by someone he knew who knew them.
Yeah, Alvin Baxter?
An American I got to know on the boat.
Well, you seem to have enjoyed the sea voyage. How did you find New York?
Oh, it's thrilling. I wish you could see Elizabeth's apartment. It's on the 14th floor overlooking the Hudson River. She's longing for James to go over and stay with her. Got all sorts of messages for him. He's a bore to go off to France like that.
Well, he's touring the battlefields, wanted to visit the graves of some of his friends.
Yes, I suppose I can understand that. How are the children? I'm longing to see them.
They're at the sea for Easter.
William's loving Summerfields. His form master is Mr. Ingeford, a Swedish origin known to the boys as Ingeford. He gave William quite a good report last term.
Oh, good.
And Alice is at day school now, Miss Fawnces.
Luncheon's.
Thank you, Hudson. Come along, darling. You must be ravenous after all that sea air.
That's what Virginia told you when during the opening of the exhibition this afternoon. Sorry to desert you just as you get home.
This is a pity you can't come with us, but it's an official invitation.
Oh, I'll go sometime. I must unpack this afternoon.